Hi everyone and welcome back to Interview Chronicles Season 4. Today we are in the 38th episode of the series and we have Rishita who has been recently placed at Honeywell as a part of her campus placements at VIT. She is here to share her interview experience with us, but before we talk to her, let's look at the eligibility criteria for this company. So students from all branches were eligible provided they had a CGPA of 6 or 60% in their 10th, 12th as well as in their pursuing degree and also provided they have no standing arrears. Now, let's go ahead and talk to Rishita and understand her experience interviewing for this company. Hi, Rishita. Firstly, welcome to my channel and congratulations on your placement.
Thank you.
So, would you like to introduce yourself first?
Yeah. Firstly, thank you for inviting me today. And hello, guys. My name is Kalluri Rishita and I'm currently doing my BTech in Computer Science and Engineering with a specialization of Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning in Velour Institute of Technology, Andhra Pradesh. I recently got placed in Honeywell company.
Okay, that's great. Thank you so much. You can tell us about the placement process, like how many rounds were there and what they had.
Yeah, sure. And firstly, Honeywell Technology Solution is a product-based company which offered a super dream internship with a full-term employment based on the performance that we have done in the internship. And coming to the placement process at the Honeywell, it consists of four rounds. For the first round, we have to apply on the NEO portal based on the criteria and the job description that had given by the company. And for the pre-placement talk, around 7,000 people were shortlisted for the pre-placement talk and the online assessment. The online assessment was conducted, was a coding test conducted on HackerRank. And the most of the questions were focused on array list, dynamic programming, and graphs. There were consisted of three coding questions. Two of the coding questions were easy to medium, while one coding question was a difficult level, and it was based on the graphs. Basically, I recommend that it's very important to practice the competitive programming in order to tackle these type of hard level graphs and trees based questions for any test in the and the interviews for the mainly for the product based companies. And around 30 September they announced the shortlisted from the company. Around 600 people were shortlisted for the interviews, and the interviews were scheduled with 400 and 200 people, like batch. They were conducted with two batches, and for the first batch they conducted on 1st October, and for the second batch they conducted on 3rd October. So mainly during the interview they mainly focused about the technical background and the internships and the projects that you had done and the projects that you had placed in your resume. For me, in my case, the interviewer had begun with discussing the technical parts of the projects that I had done. They asked me about the ML models that you are developed and how the ML models you, why, what is the reason behind the model you have chosen and how do you measure the model's accuracy and how do you handle the data and if, how do you take the imbalanced data and convert into the balance. Like this, they have asked a few technical parts and few technical coding questions also. And they followed by asked with a SQL query. And basic OOPs related concepts were also covered along with one behavioral question. For me, they have asked only one behavioral question and there was no HR round for this. We thought of there will be a second level of HR round or second level of coding round. But due to the time consistency, they did not conduct about the HR round. Mm. And after 2 days, they had sent the shortlisted student names. Around 30 people were shortlisted for the internship and the full time.
Mm. Okay. Okay, that's great. Thank you so much for sharing your experience. And do you have any suggestions for your juniors or for other people who are trying to get good placements?
Yeah, so basically the entire placement process can be a bit stressful and you may face rejections and sometimes you may feel lonely and you may feel discouraged So be calm and trust your process and go with your flow, with your consistent, and do always be well prepared with your resume and the projects and the technical parts you have, technical parts you have used in the projects. And I would recommend to daily do coding questions medium to hard level, and be well prepared with your resume and projects. I would 100% recommend all the people to prepare the cheat sheets and the notes on your own, so that it will be very beneficial for your interview process. And at the time of interview, you will be very stressful and you will be very conscious. So you have to be very well prepared with your concepts, and prepare a to-do task list and structure task list at the time of interview. So because at the time of interview, you will be very conscious, you will be very unconscious with what topics they will ask and what time, what type of questions they will be asked. So prepare a structure type of learning in the time that you have for your interview. And I would always recommend that you to be very confident.
Okay, thank you so much for sharing your experience and for the suggestions. I'm sure it will help many people. Thank you.
Thank you. And thank you for this interview.
Thank you all for watching. Please do like, share, and subscribe. And let me know which company you would like next.